This boat is licensed to carry 600 people, and we do have enough equipment for that many. And in the unlikely event of any sort of emergency, of any sort of accident, there is a computer that does it for us. But we don't like to use it. We prefer to do a commentary ourselves. Now, would that be okay, a live commentary?
Boy, if you can with us.
Okay, that's what I think. Hopefully it does add to the trip. And you start with the column to your left-hand side, the tall stone Egyptian obelisk that is called Cleopatra's Needle. This is London's oldest monument. It's said to be 3,500 years old. It was built by an 80% female workforce. And it is known all over London as the Ladies' Bridge. The ladies, they've done a fantastic job, and some of you, I'm sure, be pleased to know that is the only bridge ever built on time. And under budget, a brilliant job. The concrete building here on your right, with the electronic sign. This is London's Royal National Theatre. Inside that building, there's three theatres, and there's... That was part of the New Zealand Navy years ago. It is now on the river as a livery hall for the Honourable Company of the Master Mariners. So, retired sea captains. Looking on your right hand side, you've got a golden sandy beach. Look at that. It's one of the best beaches in the world. Tropical foreshore. The tide is rising now. In about 20 minutes' time, that beach will be complete at the very top. The letters you can see, they spell out OXO. The larger balcony at the top, that's a restaurant. It's run by Harvey Nichols. And it gets voted as one of the top five restaurants in the whole of London.
Thanks, I'm bored.
And you've got a taller tower block, just here on your right, the glass tower block. This is number one at Blackfriars. And it is an apartment building, a bedroom apartment in that building for £10 million.
Damn it.
I bought one and they are very nice. You do get good things. They sold the penthouse for 27 million. They have a number one Blackfriars here on your right. They have a number one Tower Bridge and a number one Canary Wharf. Very expensive riverside apartments. These bridges, the Blackfriars bridges, these are the lowest bridges you pass through on the journey. There won't be too much room above the boat.
Look at this.
You don't have to worry. It's the biggest sightseeing boat on the ferry, so sometimes you do get stuck because of the bridges that we just went through back then. St. Paul's Cathedral up to your left.
That was for sure. Shadow London is just city. City. But the ball is sleeping all the lonely. Chili soil and
that. So St. Paul's up to your left, the dome and the cross. It stands 365 feet tall. 1 foot of St. Paul's, it represents a day of the year. You can go to the top of that dome. If you look above, you can see railings going around the top. And that is a viewing. If you go to St. Paul's on a Sunday, it's free to visit. So bear that in mind, every Sunday throughout the year is free of charge. The viewing area is closed on a Sunday, but you can walk around the whole of the inside.
Oh,
If you get there early enough to the cathedral, you can watch the Sunday service. It's a quiet cathedral. Most people, they drop in a little note, 5, 10, 20, depending how much you've enjoyed it, and they call it a silent collection, an older tradition. And behind you to your right, you've got the white round building with the fat sides. Every single day throughout the summer, they perform William Shakespeare's plays. And the plays, they're done traditionally, exactly as they were performed in the 1500s. So for live entertainment in London, £5 is great value for money. And is everyone enjoying the live commentary so far? Here on your right hand side, to Sir Francis Drake's Golden Hind. And Francis Drake, he was the first English captain that sailed a ship around the world.
Oh, boy,
and he did that journey on a ship that was identical to that one, a full working ship. There on your right. This bridge is a London Bridge. This is it. Don't be too disappointed. The name isn't written on it. There, left and right of you. And a London Bridge has stood here for 2,000 years. This bridge, it was sinking into the mud. And they sold it to an American businessman called Robert McCulloch. They tore the bridge down and they shipped it off. And then they rebuilt it in America. It was rebuilt in Arizona.
Residential or something?
Rebuilt in the desert to cross a man-made lake. The Lake Havasu in Arizona as a tourist attraction. That was the fourth London Bridge. This is my friend here. Getting in our way a little bit. The Shard is on your right. Western Europe's tallest building. It stands 1,016 feet tall. You can visit the top of that building. There is a viewing area. It's on the 72nd floor. I've never been up there, to be honest, but I'd imagine that's where you get the best views. Right up the Shard, the 72nd floor. They designed that building to look like a piece of broken glass that's fallen from the sky. People always think that the top is not finished yet, but it is just the piece of a broken glass.
Oh, a bridge.
Designed by an Italian called Lorenzo Piero. And here on your right, the warship, the HMS Belfast. This warship is permanently on the river as a museum, a tourist attraction.
What was that?
Built in Northern Ireland, built in Belfast, built in the same shipyard as the Titanic, the ill-fated ship. Last firing the guns during the Korean War campaign, where she was flagship for the United Nations.
آپارتمان زیاد نیست. آه این رنگات ها. یه میگه موبایل فون لنده شبیه تلفن هم نمیگه که بله از سک من موزه جواهرات سلطنتی چه بغل تاوره این شهرداری لنده.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, you can see Tower Bridge in front of us. Don't worry about standing up just
Tower
yet.
Bridge.
Don't worry about coming to the front to get a photo. We're not going to rush you into Tower Pier, which is there to your left. very shortly will turn the domes around, and that you will get a side on view. So it's a much better photo. So wait to take your photo and do it as we turn. And on your left, you've got another picture there. Look, a view of the Tower of London. The castle, it dates back to 1078, over 1,000 years of history, and the castle has been well used. Used as a royal mint, a royal observatory, and even a zoo at one time. I'm sure you know it better as a place of torture, imprisonment and execution, where traitors were took years ago. Traitors, they don't go there anymore, and the castle is now a tourist attraction. And it is one of the best places that you can visit while you are here in London. The famous castle, the Tower of London, home now to the crown jewels.
They go from the crown jewels.
We're turning the boat, and then you can see the
river.
And you get a great photo as we turn. The middle of the bridge, they lift it up so ships can come into London. The double decker bus right in the middle, look, time perfect. It's a great photo. They lift up the middle so the ships can come into London.
That's nice.
Of course, you do have to be very lucky to see Tower Bridge and lift up, to be in the right place at the right time. They only... And they only open the bridge when they need it to lift, and it can only be a few times a month, and it only takes 90 seconds to lift to its full upright position. So you have to be in the area, and as the gentleman there, being in the right place at the right time. Anybody can book the bridge to open, anybody at all. You just need to give them 24 hours notice. And it is as simple as booking a bridge lift. And you can see Tower Pier to your right. We're going to turn the boat again, but this time just to stop alongside the pier. Now, ladies and gentlemen, stay seated until we are safely tied up. In case the boat bumps into the pier, just stay in your seats. Avoiding any accidents, please do hold on as best you can. In case the boat bumps, it probably won't, but just in case. Now, here at Tower Pier, go to boarding point B with your return tickets, and the next boat will take you back. So this boat goes down the river this way to Greenwich, change boats to return back to Westminster and the London Eye. Thank you all very much for your kind attention along the way. I hope you did enjoy the trip, and I hope you enjoyed the commentary as well.
Italy. They would cross each other's path. There it is. Oh, double munition. It's a cool one. محل گذر این هست بودخانه نسبتا شروع آمده تا یکی دیگه چی شده بابا سیتی کروز هستی چندین در شرکت اینجا کاره سیتی کروز یک شد شرکت هم خوب در میرم و لحظات هست انام جمع میکنه مردم همه توی پول میریزن توی برلک ها اینه تا دستی که تابستیم چیزش کنیه هرچی در بیان یاد همه در
لیف کنم
همه پاشدن لیفتشو ببینم
And to tell you how lucky you are, I've worked on this river for 16 years now. And I've only seen this bridge open about 1,000 times. So you are very lucky. No, I'm only joking. It doesn't happen very often, honestly, that we are in the right place at the right time.
Well, after the right time.
You can see the tall passenger boat coming up through the bridge, the Dixie Queen. The Dixie Queen, the biggest passenger boat on the Thames, the largest capacity. See, they need the bridge to lift up. The bridge, it can lift all the way up. The two centre parts, they do go up to a full 90 degree angle. But they only do that for Her Majesty the Queen. When the Queen goes down through the bridge, they lift it all the way up. She doesn't need to be on a tall-masted boat. She can do it on that wherever she is. She was on a boat right at the front of the pageant. And then when she went through, it was lifted all the way up. When she got the other side of the bridge, they dropped it down 10%. So they only lift it all the way up for the Queen.
The bridge up close, look. Just going underneath.
The bridge was built in 1894. So it is only 120 years old. But they built it to look older, just so it blends in with the castle, the Tower of London, that, as you remember, is next door. The stonework is just put there for decoration. It is an iron and steel bridge. If they take the stonework away, they can still lift the bridge up and down. So it was just put there so it blends in with the castle, the Tower of London.
Okay.
Thank you. Now again, we have to mention the safety that's on the boat. We're on the way to Greenwich now, and we have to point out once again that we come fully equipped with life-saving equipment. Everything is clearly marked around the boat. Life rafts around the outer room.
Bye bye.
And along the way, I'll point out a few of the buildings. Carry on with the commentary I was doing down to Tower Pier. As you can see by looking around you now, there isn't too much to point out. I'll give it a go and hopefully it does add to the trip. Apartment buildings to your left, green glass apartments. These buildings, they are designed to look. Now, I don't know what medication the designer was on at the time, but they are built to look like. The slanted roof is a cap, a soldier's beret. The square back is a backpack, and the aerial on the top, a rifle and a bayonet. There you go, soldiers, there to your left. And if you follow the river along to your left, a Victorian apartment building is called Oliver's Wharf. This was a warehouse years ago, converted now into apartments. And famous people have lived in this building. Over the years, you've had Robert De Niro, Dame Helen Mirren, and then you have had the singer, the actress, Cher, all living in that building. Dame Helen Mirren owned the top floor, the penthouse. She moved, she wrote a letter complaining to City Cruises because she said that people were turning up at her apartment. Every day she said that she was being harassed. She blamed it on the people on the boats telling the passengers where she lived. And because we'd never stopped pointing out where she lived, she became so fed up, she moved. She moved at just around the corner. The Thames River Police. They are the oldest uniformed police force in the world. They date back to 1798 and they're still running today. They started up the police force on the Thames to tackle thieving and piracy. Different types of cargo delivered from all over the world, and some of it was very expensive. And a lot of it, well, all of it was stored in these buildings. Left and right of the boat, you would have just seen warehouses storing the cargo that was being delivered. And they say that 30% of that cargo was being stolen. So, to try and tackle the problem, the Thames Police. A pub on your right, some of the Pilgrim Fathers were local men from South London in Rotherham.
آپارتمان از کلی بغلی چقدر قیمت شد اونم مانهاتان کناریز اسمش کناری
Here on your left hand side is the Devil's Tavern because of the criminals that were going in. You'd have pickpockets, thieves and murderers, press gangers, all going into that pub. The Prospect of Whitby, or the Devil's Tavern. You would find press gangers in a lot of these riverside pubs. Press gangers, they were going into the pub and they were looking for young men that had too much to drink. They would find them in the pubs, of course, and they would get so drunk, the young men. The press wanted to join the Navy years ago because the life expectancy was maybe 1 or 2 years. You died in battle, you picked up a horrible disease. So nobody would join. So you were forced by the press gangers to join the Navy. And the sandy coloured buildings to your left with the white arched windows. These were prisons years ago. They used to hold criminals in those buildings. They weren't held for long. They were sent to a different prison at Millbank. Up the river, Millbank Prison. The criminals were given orange suits and they had letters on their back. POM. They became prisoners of Milbank. The criminals were put onto ships. They sent the criminals away to Australia. And the first thing the Australians would see was the letters on their back. POM. Spelling out POM. Australians today, they call us the POM on the criminals' backs. Is anybody from Australia on the boat? Nobody. I would like to say welcome home there. It's wasted. There is a lot of theories as to why. One of them, they call us pomegranates because you get red faces in the sun. Prisoner of Mother England is another one. Because of the letters on their back, it's a popular theory. Just to your left, you've got narrow apartments, brown and narrow buildings. Look past the old sailing barge there, look at the apartments. The one closest to us is number 13 in Narrow Street. And that apartment was made famous by Charles Dickens. Charles Dickens lived in the attics of that pub, and it's from there he wrote novels Great Expectations and Our Mutual Friends. Both novels were in that pub.
Oh, well, it's mine had that book, sir. It's good comment to you. I don't need to speak anything, you just speak it. Well, I see. Yeah. I go. You ever been in Manhattan, better side. In Manhattan, land there. That's when you get Canaries. They call the Canaries because boat from Canaries came here, and that's what it's called, Costa Canaries. West Indies, Canaries, all these boats came and embarked at this point. But now it's a kind of commercial side.
Canary Wharf is to your left-hand side. Canary Wharf is, of course, the working complex, the financial district of London.
Yeah.
The main building, the one with the pyramid top, the official name of that building is number one at Canada Square. But you may know it better as the Canary Wharf Tower. Canary Wharf is the name of the whole area, not the building. It stands 850 feet tall, and it used to be the tallest building in the whole of Europe. Nowhere near the tallest building today, but it is the main one in that area. We always recommend to visit Canary Wharf, but remember you have to bear in mind that it is a working complex. So if you go there Monday to Friday, it's very busy. Monday to Friday, 9 to 5, they say there's well over 100,000 workers. The bankers go home, that's when you visit. Underneath the buildings is a massive shopping centre. And it's full up with bars and restaurants as well. So here's a nice place to go, something to eat or drink. But wait till it's quiet. On the weekend, do the shopping of an evening, something to eat or drink.
It's best back for the good man, hot and around there. That's a good thing. I have a آبی هنیم هم دفت بیدن چقدر به قیمتی هم روانده هم باید.
And as you get past Canary Wharf, have a look around you. There is nothing to point out. Greenwich. And once you can see Greenwich, I'll tell you as much as I can. I'll point out as much as I can that there is to see and do in the area. Greenwich is a great place to visit. It is a royal borough. A very well kept area, and we always recommend to spend a bit of time in Greenwich. Spend as much time as you've got.
Benim Birmingham Greenwich, Greenwich is where I live. So, a bit further away, but not exactly right in there. Exactly. Yeah, there is my halima.
So we... Then we stay on the pier now for 30 minutes. So you'll have an opportunity to leave and come back with us, or you get the later boat back. And they run every 40 minutes. The last one is at 6:30. So there may be a boat after us, 6:30. Every boat stops at Tower Pier, goes through to Westminster and the London Eye.
We land there, I mean, cruise up with anybody. Cruise around there. بغل رودخونه نفش هم میگه بغل درست
And I'll point out as much as I can once we start to get around the bend.
زیر آپارتمان هم اینجاست. اینا چند هستن؟ نمیگه پدر سر چند داره من دیگه و میلیون بالا هنه نیوه اینجا آپارتمان ها میلیون بالا هست من منظور از میلیون یه میلیون مانگه
As we start to get around the bend, you can see a lot of Greenwich. Blocking the view of Greenwich at the moment is a cruise ship. It's called the Viking Sun. Come up to London yesterday and it leaves tomorrow afternoon. Where that cruise ship is sitting is one of the deepest parts of the Thames. In this area, of course. On the high water, which we're near enough on now, on the high tide, there's about 20 meters of water underneath that ship. So on the low tide, there's still about 12 meters of water. And it is a naturally deep part of the Thames. And they turned it into a cruise terminal. The passengers, they join the ship and they get ferried across from Greenwich Pier. They fill the ship up with fuel and fresh water, and then they go back off. To somewhere I would imagine a bit more exotic, but they do stay here for a few days.
Are you boat cruise in Ireland? In and I just you can meet us at furthest point that cruise boats come because the river gets shallow. They can they will sink them if they go further. That's the furthest.
And you'll see a different cruise ship here at Greenwich. Every few weeks now, all the way through the summer, you see different ships. Not just the cruise ships, you'll get big naval ships. We've had aircraft carriers, tall ships, the tall sailing boats. They all stop down here at Greenwich. As it is such a deep part of the Thames, they have the tall ship festivals down here at Greenwich. Once a year, they have a festival. They have about 30 tall ships in this area. Because it is a deep part of the Thames. These are the Viking fleet of ships. We had the Viking Jupiter up here last week. This one's the Viking Sun. The Viking Star is the one that got caught in the storm a couple of months ago. Went out at sea in a storm. You might remember that. Had to get evacuated. It was all on the news. And we do normally get that one come up the Thames. I'd imagine it won't be here for a little while. So you'll find the other ones here instead. Looking past that ship now, in front of us you've got white buildings on the river. These are the Royal Naval Colleges. This is where they used to train and nurse the Royal Navy. Nowadays it's part of the Greenwich University, St. Paul's Cathedral. So having a nice look around there is always a good thing to do while we sit on the pier. And just next to those buildings, there is a maritime museum, and the museum is free to visit. So if you are stopping in Greenwich, it's a brilliant place to go, especially for the children. and it's free of charge. Once you get past this ship, you'll see another tall-masted boat. It's got three tall masts, and it's called the Cutty Sark. The Cutty Sark was a famous tea clipper, and it is now permanently at Greenwich. It was built in the 1800s, built in Scotland, and it carried tea into London. Once we get past the ship, look at the top of the hill, look past the Cutty Sark. You can now see the green dome, the tea mast, and the red ball. That is the Greenwich Observatory. That is where the meridian line passes through Greenwich. That's the point where the east meets the west. And it is the ball drops. As the ball drops, it sets 1 o'clock GMT, Greenwich Mean Time.
God bless you, Greenwich.
24 time zones around the world. Every one of them is set by GMT. So wherever you go, your time is calculated. It comes back to Greenwich. Greenwich, this is where time begins. Greenwich is the center of the universe.
اینا قصر تابستونی ملکی و اینا بوده.
And I would imagine that you are impressed.
Residence تابستونی.
And you are glad you came. But you have arrived.
I was the summer residence.
And we are just waiting to get alongside the queen. We had a bit of an event here on the Thames today, the barge driving event. The race, you might have noticed earlier on, with the barges that were being rowed up through the bridges. They started, if you see all that, it started here at Greenwich and it finished at Westminster. So all of the passenger boats that were following the race, they end up back here at Greenwich, and they are sitting alongside the pier. But once we've got a space, we'll get into the pier and you'll be able to leave. Now, we sit on the pier for a short while now. It'll be about 20 minutes that we stay here before we go back. Do your best to stay in your seats until we are safely alongside. Just in case the boat does bump, do stay in your seats. Now, thank you all for listening, for your kind attention along the way. Not as much to point out in this part of the trip as you saw, but hopefully you enjoyed it. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope the commentary as well does add to the journey. As we mentioned, me and my friend are driving the boat here. We're not tour guides, just members of the crew. We're Tim's Waterman, and he is an